Hey guys, thanks for tuning in today. I figured, you know what? What's a better time now than now than now than now than right now than doing a Batman review? You know why? Because you can never say no to the bat. And trust me, you don't want to do that. So I present to you none other than the Bat. And here we go. Escape got stuck. So I picked this up from a Target not too long ago. So, one more. So, first off, before we get to the bat, we're going to take a look at the box. And as you can see, it was on sale. That's what really caught my eye. I'm like, you know what? Batman? Yes. A sale? Even better. And then Batman again beats the first two. So as you can see, it is part of the Multiverse line. I have seen some of these around. The Caped Crusader defends Gotham City against the world's most dangerous criminal masterminds. And he deals with some real nutcases, by all means. So look in the back. We got Batman, we got Joker, and Poison Ivy. I did not see the other two. If I did, I probably would have gotten that Joker. But that's fine, because I got Batman. There's Batman on the side, Batman on the side, and Batman on the back, and also, again, Batman on the front. So, let's go into some of the cool little details with this figure. So, I'm not too sure. What really caught my eye mainly was it looked like the Michael Keaton Batman. The Michael Keaton Batman from the first Batman movie, where the suit had, like, the built-in muscle suit over the one that was from Batman Returns, where it had more like kind of looked like armor plating, especially on like the where the abs are. So I just saw this and I couldn't say no. I honestly couldn't. I looked at it and I looked at it again, and then I'm like, yeah, I'll grab it. So he's got really, really good detail in the face. I wish it would show in really good on the camera, but he's got perfect, awesome sculpt. Does have really good posability. He can do a really mean T pose. His arms can do a full 360 at the shoulder. Oh, let's see. There we go. I'm like, don't get stuck, man. Don't get stuck. Does have a swivel at the bicep, and he does have an elbow. And his hands can do a full 360. Not that, I mean, he would ever have to do that. But it's a thing. It's a thing it can do. Does have a really good ab crunch. So he's looking for clues, or he dropped his bat nachos. He does have a waist swivel. And he does have about that much posability for the leg, kicking outwards, kicking backwards, and kicking forwards. He does have a double joint at the knee, and for some reason, maybe because mine's just out of the box, this is the first time messing around with it, so, but believe me, he does, and he does have a swivel at the thigh, too, so his thigh can do a full 360. He does have a swivel and a ball joint at his ankle, so he has really good ankle posability. Some really good poses. And the thing I think is really cool about this is that they gave him an actual cloth cape. So that's a bonus point. He does come with a really cool accessory. He does come with his grappling hook. And there's the gun part of the grappling gun. And he's got the batarang at the end with an actual rope. And if you want, you can actually plug it out of the barrel. And he can hold it like a regular gun, or in his case, grappling hooks. So you can put that in his hand. Everything's really fresh and real good on it still, so it's going to take a while for the plastics to kind of get used to being able to move. So, I mean, you can have him holding the grappling gun, put the grappling hook inside there. And if you want, you can have him put in, like, a really cool display where you can have this going upwards and it looks like he's, you know, going to shoot his grappling hook, whether to save Vicky Vale or any other innocent civilian of the city of Gotham.
Where do you want to kill me at?
So, I mean, it's a really good figure. I mean, if you guys can pick it up, if you guys are Batman fans, which I'm sure most of you guys probably are, this would look excellent with your collection, which, in my case, I don't really have too many DC figures here, so he might go on the shelf with my MCU figures, my other Marvel figures, and my Lightning Collection Power Ranger figures. So, you know what? The Rangers and the Avengers might need some help from the Batman.
Why do you want to kill me? Why do you want to kill me?
So, I'm just ecstatic to have this figure. I mean, it's been a long time since I've bought a Batman figure, since I got one, anyways. BTNT Toys, if you guys heard of them. You guys probably have. If you guys live here in Utah, you guys might have heard of them. Guy that runs it gave me this Batman figure for free. So shout out to BTNT Toys. These are the original 92 Batman figures. So that's really cool. I have so many of those. Which is, you know, you can never have too much Batman. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, again, it's an awesome figure. If you guys can pick this up, I would definitely do so. So, what more can I say? Oh, it's Batman. And, again, I do believe this is based off of possibly the 1989 Batman movie by Tim Burton, Michael Keaton. You got Nicholson. That'd be a good... Oh, man. Could you imagine that, having a Nicholson Batman figure of Joker? That'd be cool. So, this is going to be the closest I can probably get to a Michael Keaton Batman figure that's updated anyway. So, thank you guys for watching. Thank you so much. Remember, Batman is the hero we deserve and the hero that we need. So, salutations and good night to all you Dark Knights. Thanks for watching. Bye.